All right, 1, 2, 3.
Hello, my name is Sarthak Bhardwaj.
And I'm Nishant Mittal.
And welcome to the very first episode of I Read This Book. Before we proceed any further, Nishant, tell everyone what this project is about.
So Sarthak and I have been doing a lot of, reading with a campaign called 52 Books in a Year. So we read a book almost every week and then we post its review on Facebook, Instagram and elsewhere. So now we thought, instead of posting those textual reviews, why don't we talk about those books on tape, So everybody could probably listen to these conversations, hopefully get inspired, hopefully read the book, hopefully give us suggestions so we can get to learn and improve ourselves. So that was the idea. Create an atmosphere of reading, positivity. So
that's a beautiful conceptualization of what we're trying to do here. And the book we are discussing in today's episode is the one right in front of you, Big Billion Startup. Nishant is the one who has read this book. So Nishant, give me a quick review of this book, what it's about.
The Big Billion Startup is a 360 degree, journalistic account of Flipkart. Right from inception to development to chaos, and then finally the acquisition by Walmart for $20 billion.
Wow.
This story is incredible, and it's very, very, very well put, very researched, deeply researched by Mihir Dalal. And what's fascinating is that there's a lot we don't know about the ones we think we know everything about. So, Flipkart is very famous. We think that we know everything about the story, but there's more than meets the eye.
Okay, so what's the one thing which you feel not a lot of people know about Flipkart, but should know about it? Was something like that revealed in this book?
Yes, a lot of it. I mean, this book is full of anecdotes like that, where people would just be stunned by the way things have gone at the company.
Share one.
Okay, so Flipkart was trying to raise money.
Okay,
and it wasn't being able to raise money because Indian investors were very, very wary of the concept of selling books online at the time, 2007. Nobody trusted internet that much.
Sorry to interrupt you, but was it just books that Flipkart was initially trying to sell?
Yes, initially.
Just books?
Just books, and then it, went on to other categories.
Okay.
So it finally got an investor called Axel, which had promised to invest $1 million for a valuation of $5 million. Okay. And Flipkart was just doing fine with that. It was content. And there was this huge investor called Leaf Excel, who nobody in India knew about at that time, who was scouting for Indian startups for investment purposes. So he hired BCG, Boston Consulting Group, and asked for the interesting startups he could explore. Flipkart wasn't on that list.
Oh, man.
They weren't on that list. And one day, while on an airplane or something, Leaf Excel was making random searches on Google India, thinking like an Indian, about the products. And on every search query, Flipkart was at the top.
Oh, so was Flipkart really that prevalent already?
It wasn't. But the beauty is that Flipkart had gamed the Google search engine optimization so well that on every category, even the ones in which Flipkart didn't have products, you'll see the Flipkart results on the top. And Leaf Excel was surprised. He was amazed. He thought, I need to talk to these guys.
Yeah.
He called the customer care number. Wo se hame wahan delivery nahi hoti. And then he reached out to the founders through mail. And founders said that founders didn't find him legitimate because he was Leaf Excel. He was very reclusive. They couldn't read about him on the internet much.
Okay.
So they totally ignored the guy. Then Leaf Excel, the biggest investor in the space, reached out to Deep Kalra, the founder of Make My Trip. And he asked him to connect to the founders. And that's what happened. And that's how Leaf Excel became the king and the kingmaker of Flipkart and eventually, lead to its meteoric rise.
That's insane, man.
It's fucking insane. It's insane in the membrane. It's unbelievable, man. Yes, yes.
All right. Well, although the reason is quite obvious now, but I'd still like to ask you, what made you pick this book up? I believe it's a very recent book. It has just come out, right?
It's come out it came out on October 7th, I think.
Oh.
And I got my copy on 10th.
Oh, wow.
I am an entrepreneur. I wish to learn about entrepreneurs. And the thing is, you know, when I'm trying to read books, I'm always, almost always reading books which are written in the West. Ab wo desi nahi hota wo tarika. Americans and Europeans have a different way of working. India bahut alag hai. India mein log alag tarike se baat karte hain, kaam karte hain, behave karte hain. Kuch alag hi hai India ka scene. पीछे से आते हैं लोग यहाँ पे.
बट ये जो अलग है सीन,
हाँ,
ये बेहतर है या बुरा है?
ये तो कोई नहीं कह सकता.
मतलब address this question once you're done talking about what you were saying, you know?
नहीं, मतलब बेहतर comparative नहीं हो सकते. We cannot be comparative of two cultures. But the point is, culture is very individual. अमेरिकी बात सीख के इंडिया में धंधा तो नहीं चलेगा.
Yeah, you said that. I mean.
So this book tells you how Indians have done things and how they could make it. So this is as Indian as it gets. It's a very important story for the Indian ecosystem.
Right.
And I'm glad these kinds of books are coming out. Golden Tap, this, Stay Hungry, Stay Foolish, and a lot of these books, they're doing a very good job.
That's great. Well, since this is a relatively new book and the author, well, he's relatively unknown too, and or maybe he isn't, I don't know. So tell me a little about his style of narration. How well does he narrate a story, and how well does he convey the central ideas that he's trying to argue?
A beautiful question. So what happens is, he's a journalist, and he has been very thorough about the research around Flipkart. So he hasn't tried to go too global, macroscopic in his approach. He has focused on this company, the starting guys, everybody who he could interview, he's done it. It's not a very philosophically bound book.
It's not supposed to be.
It's not something like All the President's Men was in that context. It's a journalistic masterpiece.
Okay.
But this is a journalistic masterpiece too. Even though it's not written like a literature piece, you know, it's a very play-by-play account of the story. So it moves like a story, and it's going to be a motion picture. The book says it's going to be a movie.
Really?
Yeah. So,
well, that's great.
Yeah,
that's great.
Success, of course.
That's truly a real success of the book. Well, my next question is, would you recommend this book to the public at large? Because, well, I understand that you're an entrepreneur and why you would be fascinated to read a business-related book. However, someone who is studying, let's say, English might not be as fascinated with the concepts discussed in this book. So would you still recommend this book to public at large?
I would, because this is an important story. I don't care if Sachin and Bilni Bansal were marathon runners, and if they had this story, I would still read it. It's not just business which is important in this context. It's an important story. It's two guys from Chandigarh, you know, going to build the biggest company in the space.
And succeeding.
And defying all odds. So if you asked even 2 years ago, 3 years ago, smartest guys in any room, none of them would have been bullish about the Flipkart story. Everybody said that this company is going to fail. But somehow they could survive. And it's not that those guys were stupid or they were jealous. They said that because it's truly a strange story, and this strange story is within the book.
No, that's right, but I think the idea of Flipkart wasn't novel. Amazon had already done that globally, and I'm sure there were other companies also which were doing the same thing. So while I do admit that in the Indian e-commerce industry it was a major breakthrough, but in terms of entrepreneurial success, it didn't add anything new to the market, did it?
It did add everything new to the market. It created the market. It built the Indian entrepreneurial market. See, ideas don't mean shit. You know, ideas are dime a dozen. You and I can come here and talk about ideas. It's just the fucking skin in the game, you know. It's about how people make those ideas run on the ground. That matters. And only these guys could do it. And these guys have done it better than anybody else. The companies which, you were right, Myntra came before Flipkart, and it got acquired by Flipkart.
Oh yeah, because,
you know?
Wow.
Yeah. Even though it came before, it raised money before Flipkart, it had the same clutch of investors, but Flipkart won. Flipkart eventually acquired Myntra.
Well, interesting point. Now, Flipkart managed to acquire Myntra, but Flipkart itself was purchased or bought by Walmart, right? Now, in this grand scheme of things, where do you find Flipkart to be placed in the battle between Amazon and Flipkart towards gaining eventual dominance in the Indian e-commerce industry?
It's a good, it's a $100 billion question, which will be the size of our e-commerce industry very soon. Flipkart is already dominating the Indian market, despite of a lot of apprehensions on a lot of metro. Yeah, that's like, you know, people could discuss what who do you think is winning, but numbers say that Flipkart is winning, and Flipkart is in very safe hands. Walmart is a very strong company, and it's going to be an uphill task for Amazon to come close. It'll keep giving tough competition, but will it be a clear winner? Very hard to say.
That's a great summation of your view. As an entrepreneur and someone who has been running a startup for a while now, do you think this book offers a good learning experience? And do you feel that other entrepreneurs who are just starting out on their journey will learn something from the journey of Flipkart, especially as told by Mihir Dalal in this book?
Fucking eh? There's a lot to learn from this story, of course. That's why I picked it. And I did get the wisdom nuggets I was hoping for. One of them is that fundraising is a pull event. And it's like miraculous. It happens miraculously, serendipitously. But the best ones are pull events. What I mean by that is when we are, as entrepreneurs, we're trying to pitch to investors. We're trying to get investment. You know, best investments happen when investors come to Flipkart. Did I tell you the story about leaflets?
Right at the beginning.
Yeah, so that was my major learning.
Exactly.
And of course, operational excellence goes without saying, but a lot of things to learn from Flipkart, guys. The major thing, which I forgot, is that you should be ruthless. You should be, you know, very, very ruthless. You should know when to fuck, who to fuck, and how to fuck, if possible. I'm
wow,
so
right.
Sorry if that's censored.
Yeah, you're gonna hear a lot of beep beeps here.
Yeah.
Well, I think you've truly encapsulated the central ideas of the book. I haven't read it, but I'm really fascinated to know what's in it, and I'll definitely go for it. And this is what I want from our viewers, you know, the books we're discussing, if they could pick it up and relay their thoughts as to what they thought about the particular book.
You could join our campaign, which is 52 books in a year. You know, it's going to be 2020. So hashtag 52 books in 2020 on Twitter, on Facebook, on Instagram. You could be a part of that campaign. You could run that campaign for us.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, we could talk about books. If you want us to review a book and talk about a book here, please do that. If we can engage offline, and if we click, you could be a part of this
podcast. So,
and this could be a beautiful thing where we're talking and reading more.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You know, gyan bat raha hai jagah.
Yeah, hopefully.
And I think that is a good place to end the very
first
episode.
This is good fun. I love
this book.
Yes.
And see you next time.
So you can please, if you like this video, you could let us know in comments. If you have suggestions, let us know. Like, share, and subscribe. If you don't, fuck.
Okay.